Hey, what's up? It's Jared with State of Tech, and the day has finally arrived. We can now send money to each other through iMessage, which I think is pretty cool. I mean, I have been using Venmo for a while, and Venmo's been really good for sending money to people. I love the fact that there's no fee as long as the money's coming from either my Venmo account or from my checking account. And Apple Pay Cash is essentially the same situation. For any of your friends or family that have iPhones as well, that are running the latest version of iOS, which is going to be required 11.2 or newer, you're going to be able to send each other cash on the device, which I think is pretty cool. So I'm going to walk you through the process of how to do this. Now, this rolled out really recently to everybody, and if you have updated your phone to the latest software, then you should have seen something. When you went into your Messages app, it asked me to set it all up. Same thing on my iPad once I updated, and then once I updated my Apple Watch to watch OS 4.2, it also had the option. I just had to go through a slightly different process. So let's go ahead and take a look at what that looks like. So you're seeing my screen right here. If I go into a text message, I'm going to go into a text message with James, and you can see that I have my Apple Pay icon down there in the apps. Now, in order to set that up, we're going to go through that process really quick. I disabled mine, so my setup process isn't going to take as long as yours will for the first time, but I'll walk you through the process. So you go into your settings app and go down to Wallet and Apple Pay. If you're doing this manually, if you're not seeing anything show up or whatnot, then this is the process. But I'm going to go ahead and activate Apple Pay Cash, and then it's going to ask for my password. I can go ahead and paste that in and hit sign in, and then it's going to go through the process. And this would be the process that that you would see in your Messages app for that first time. So you'll see this Apple Pay Cash, and it'll explain what to do. You'll click continue. It'll say setting up Apple Pay Cash. It'll ask you a couple of questions and verify it, and it's set up. This process for me is going to take less time because I've already done it once. And now you'll see my Apple Pay Cash card is in my list of available cards here, which is great. So let's go back to my main screen. And if I go into my wallet app, you're going to see that I have my Apple Pay Cash card in there as well. When people send you money, or if you preload your Apple Pay Cash card with money, you can use Apple Pay with this card. So that means if you go to a store or whatever that accepts Apple Pay, if you have a balance on your Apple Pay Cash card, you can make a payment that way. Alternatively, you can also send money to people from your Apple Pay Cash card balance as well. So that's pretty cool. I like the way that that works. If you click on that little I, you can see we have add money or transfer to bank. Now, if I wanted to add money to my card, I would tap on that. I can then tap a dollar amount or type in any dollar amount and click on add. And then it's going to go ahead and suggest that it funds from an account like my Visa debit card. So I'll go ahead and double tap on that, and it's going to go ahead and Face ID and process that, and then add that $10. And I even got a push notification letting me know. So I now have $10 in my Apple Pay Cash. Now, if I wanted to transfer that back, or say somebody sends you some money and you want to send it back to your bank account, you would tap transfer to bank. You would add a bank account, which means you're going to have to add in the banking account number and the number for your bank so that you can transfer. That's like on your checkbook, or you can go into your online banking and get the routing number and your bank account number and put that in. That will be required to transfer money back, and it's just a quick and easy process to set that up. So the fun part is actually sending cash to people, and you do that through a text message. Now, for example, if I was to text message James here, I can type him a message, but I can also tap on the Apple Pay app that is showing up. Now, if you don't see those, it's because you need to tap on the little app icon and then tap on the Apple Pay app icon there. So it's going to ask me to double click to pay. So I'm going to go ahead and double tap my side button here on my iPhone 10 to pay. Process may be slightly different if you're on a different version of an iPhone. And I've just sent James a dollar. Now, James is going to hopefully text message me here and say, hey, I thought it was $5, because the cool thing is when somebody sends you a text message and it includes a dollar amount, you can actually tap on that dollar amount and it's going to automatically create a payment. So I can tap on that five and see it automatically added that right there. And I could say, nope, I'm not giving you five. I'm just going to knock that down to one. Or maybe I mess that up and I can actually increase that. So it's pretty cool. I really like the way that this works. It's super simple. It's right within the Messages app, and it's already part of the process and the way that we use our device. So I really think that that's cool. So we're gonna go on over to the iPad and do the exact same thing, because I wanna show you just how easy it is to do this on an iPad. So I already have Apple Pay Cash enabled. You could even see over here in the text message feed, because I have my text messages and everything syncing between my Apple devices, that it shows the dollar that I paid James and even that $5 link over here. Now, I have the Google keyboard up, and so I'm going to need to switch my keyboard back to the keyboard, the Apple keyboard, and I can go ahead and tap on the apps here, and you can see the Apple Pay app is already right there. Or if I wasn't in this app, I was just in the keyboard, I could tap on that $5, it loads up right here. Apple just made this super easy. So it doesn't matter what device I have in front of me, it's gonna automatically allow me to make a payment to them. So that's pretty cool. Now, lastly, I have my Apple Watch over here, and the Apple Watch also has it. The Apple Watch process of setting this up is a little bit different. You're gonna have to make sure that the Apple Watch is updated to version 4.2. You'll go into your Apple Watch app here, and then you're going to need to go down to Wallet and Apple Pay and enable Pay Cash. You can see here that it's updated. It even shows that I only have $9 in there now instead of 10, and all that good stuff. So everything is right in here. This is fantastic. And so now if I want to send a payment, I can go right into a text message. So I'll just go into the Messages app here. And so I have my messages. I'll tap on the message from James. It shows the dollar that I paid him. It shows that, hey, I thought it was five, and I could even tap on that and it will create a payment. Or I can scroll down a little bit and there's an Apple Pay button, which will then allow me to go ahead and pay him a dollar. So I'm gonna go ahead and do that, and it's gonna send him a dollar right from my watch. So I like this. It's made it super simple and easy to send payments to anybody, you know, regardless of who they are, so long as they're on iOS and they are in a text message with you. So this is great. So there's one last thing that we need to look at, and it's actually the verification process, because you do need to verify who you are. But right now I had to go into Wallet and Apple Pay, go underneath my Apple Pay Cash card and scroll down below to verify my identity, and then go through the process of verifying my identity by putting in my information and just verifying, because this has to be traceable somehow. Apple can't, you know, let people use this in malicious ways. So your Apple Pay transaction history has to be linked to you. And this verification process allows you to do that. I haven't tried, but I'm sure there's limitations if you don't verify who you are, such as the dollar amount that you could send, or maybe you can't transfer money out of your Pay Cash card into your bank account. You need to go through and verify yourself. I'm gonna go ahead and finish this verification process offline, but I wanted to show to all of you that that is something that needs to be done. So very simple to send a payment to anybody, whether you're on an iPad, an iPhone, or an Apple Watch. Definitely really cool that you're able to do this. I just wanted to walk everybody through it so that you could see what it looks like, because otherwise the only way to know what it looks like is to actually send someone cash, and maybe you're not ready to do that yet. So I wanted to make sure that you had an opportunity to see what it looked like. You know, while we're just finishing up the video, James is gonna go ahead and send me a dollar back just so that we can see what happens when that pops up on the screen. So, hey, thanks so much for checking out this video. you know, it's videos like this that help us all better understand how to use our technology. Oh, there's the payment from James. It popped right up and I can see that that payment happened. Now I have $10 back in my Apple Pay Cash account, so everything is all good and I have $10 to use until next time, or of course I could transfer that out into my bank account. So that's gonna do it for this video. Click on that subscribe button to subscribe to our channel, because we produce a lot of tips and tutorial videos like this, as well as reviews and stuff on technology in case you're interested. If you have any questions about Apple Pay that I can try and answer for you, leave that in the comment section below. I also have some links to some of these items. Maybe you were thinking about getting an iPad or an Apple Watch or a new case for your phone. There's a few links down in the description below that will take you over to Amazon, where you can see some of the cool things that are available for these devices. So, hey, thanks again for watching this video. Hope that it helped you out. If it did, give us a subscribe by clicking on that subscribe button, and we hope to see you back here soon on State of Tech. Thanks a lot.